Hi, I am Chetan from Leeco India Service. This is our Leeco Benchtop Bomb Calorimeter. This is a Windows-based instrument developed to measure the calorific content in the various organic material such as coal, coke and fuel oil. This is an isoperiodic method which we can analyze the sample between 4.5 to 8 minutes depending upon the mode which we have selected. The standard mode which we are preferring is high precision, which takes 8 minutes to analyze the sample. In that 8 minutes, 3 minutes for equilibrating and the remaining 5 minutes for sample burning time. After completing of 8 minutes, the result will be tabulated in the software. Now we will start to analyze our sample. Initially we will take sample in this crucible. First we will weigh the sample. We will tear it now. So we are doing coal sample. We will take approximately around 1 gram. And we will enter the sample weight here. Prior to place the sample, first we will put the thread, this wire, igniter wire. Actually we have two types of combustion vessel, one is thread and another is wire. This is a wire based combustion vessel. Here we have a notch so that we can easily put this wire. So now it's tight. In this wire we have actually four sections in this combustion vessel. These two for electrodes which we supply the 29 volts DC voltage, and this is for oxygen filling and this is for oxygen releasing. Now we'll place our crucible into the crucible holder. So make sure this wire will touch the sample. Okay, now it's touching. I will close the loop. We will tighten this one. Okay. This is the oxygen filling vessel. So we will give 420 PS of oxygen which is used for burning process. So it will be auto cut off, there is no need to operate. Once we press this button, it will be auto cut off at the 420 PSI. You can observe here, slowly it is rising. Once it reaches here 420 PSI, it will auto cut off. Auto cut off done. So this is the holder. Prior to putting this one, we will take 2 liters of water from this pipette. At every analysis, we need to take a fresh water from this one. This is we call as a pipette. Exactly 2 liters from this one. After 2 liters, it will be overflow and it will coming back to this reservoir. This is a reservoir tank. we took the water and we placed the water in this bucket into this jacket. Now we place the combustion vessel. We have a mark inside so that we can easily put our combustion vessel. So we have two electrodes which can be connected either side, any other side. Okay, now it's okay. We'll close the lid. We have thermistor, high precision thermistor. This is a 1/10,000 degree Celsius of high precision. So every 6 seconds it traces the temperature of the water and sends to the microprocessor, so that it is every time it is collecting the temperature of the water. And this is the stirrer. To inform temperature maintained within the bucket, we use this stirrer. Once we give analyze, the stirrer will rotate and this will start working. Now we'll close the lid. So lock it. Now we'll give the analyze FI or analyze. We'll click this one. As I told earlier, it takes 8 minutes. In that 8 minutes, 3 minutes for equilibrium. Here you can observe here, 3 minutes you are getting for equilibrating. After 3 minutes, it takes for 5 minutes for analyzing the sample. That is, sample will completely burn in that 5 minutes. The calorific value of the sample is determined by combustion of the sample in a controlled environment, which I told you earlier. We have two thermistors in the instrument. One is used for a bucket and another is used in a jacket. So in these 3 minutes, they both the temperature it matches, that is plus or minus 1 degree of tolerance. So now the temperature is matching. To match both the jacket and bucket temperature, we used heat exchanger. So you can check here the heat exchanger. This is a heat exchanger instrument. Usually we call as a chiller. Here we have heat exchanger. By using this heat exchanger, it matches both the temperature, jacket and bucket temperature. It's like a radiator. It's rotated with speed. Once the temperature is less, it rotates very slow. If the temperature is high, it makes temperature low by speed of the fan is more. Still 1.1 minutes is remaining for equilibrating. Once the 3 minutes is over, you will get a beep sound, so that sample will get fired that time through that electrodes. Point 6 minutes is remaining. Once these 3 minutes is completed, the analyzing time is 5 minutes. This is a precision mode of working. So the 3 minutes is over now. Now we can observe the discharge of fuse. It means the fire is happened. So delta T, you can observe here delta T. Now the delta T will rise according to the temperature of the water in the bucket. Let's see, now it is rising. In the figure also you can check in the map. Delta T is rising. Delta T is nothing but change in temperature. This is the funda of changing of temperature between initial to final. In this isopropyl method,
the outside temperature should not affect to the inside bucket. So the temperature is controlled atmosphere. The combustion vessel is surrounded by a water and the sample is ignited. The electronic thermometer continuously sensing the water and stirrer is making it uniformly, the temperature uniformly between the bucket, the stirrer used for that one. This is all operated by microprocessor. The microprocessor measures the temperature of the water surrounding the combustion vessel every 6 seconds. The analog to digital converter converts this output into the binary number what is stored in the memory. The difference in the water temperature between pre-fire and a post-fire is perceived by a computer where this result is corresponding. And the delta T is rising, we can observe this one, 0.58 delta T change in temperature. In this instrument we can also measure very low content of CV also by using spike method. Spike method means high content of ash, some sample will be high content of ash. In this case we used to add some kind of known value sample like benzoic acid or any like known sample acid, we will add that one. By using that known sample, it will get fire, and it is used to fire with a sample which is a high content of ash. Then rotate this, water will be continuously rotating in the instrument. We can operate this in Windows 10, Windows 7 and XP also. We can directly convey the result from this window to Excel. By sample, it will append the result to the Excel also. This is a huge advantage for user, so that each and every after analyzing, the result will go into the Excel sheet. Now the sample is analyzed, so now we will open the combustion vessel outside. Use some cloths to wipe this one so that water should not fall out. As much as possible, we pour the water back here only. Now we release the air. This is the air release knob. And we pour the water again to the reservoir. Again we take water for the next analyzing. For every analyze we need to change the water. So this is a measuring jar. So exactly 2 liters we will get from this pipette, we call it a pipette. So now we are release the air. We use tissue paper to clean. So I will open it. Slowly we have to open. Now check, our sample is completely burnt. So
This is of the working of AC funnel bomb calorimeter, LICOMED. Thank you.